is New York City ready for the big one? This region isn't known for earthquakes, but beneath the bustling streets of New York City, there are fault lines capable of significant tremors. On April 5th, 2024, a magnitude 4.8 earthquake shook the New York City area. This is actual footage from the day. The earthquake highlighted the unique nature of earthquakes along the East Coast. So let's investigate the seismic forces at play under the city.
Oh, excuse me. Hi. Hi. Did you know that we're walking on a fault line right now that produces earthquakes in New York City?
No, I absolutely did not know that.
I'm standing on one of a handful of fault lines that cuts through New York City. This is the 125th Street Fault Line, and it runs from New Jersey to 125th Street, skimming the north end of Central Park, onto Roosevelt Island and into Queens. Here, the subway is above ground, specifically to avoid the 125th Street Fault.
These faults, they're producing small earthquakes every single day. They're just so small that we don't feel them.
In 2001, there was a magnitude 2.4 earthquake caused by the 125th Street Fault that had its epicenter right here around 102nd between Park and Lex. But there have been much larger earthquakes in New York City.
The last moderate-sized earthquake was a magnitude 5 about. That happened in 1884, and that was around the Coney Island area.
A New York Times article from August 11, 1884, described a magnitude 5.2 earthquake the day before. A sharp earthquake shock passed through the city, causing the most substantial buildings to quiver. Men stopped suddenly and listened with fear to the deep grumbling beneath them. We also had two magnitude 5 earthquakes in the 18th century that were felt in New York City, one in 1737 and the other one in 1783.
But what is the origin of these earthquakes? We're not in an earthquake hotspot like the Ring of Fire. Let's do a tectonic plate refresher.
The Earth is composed of rigid plates called tectonic plates. They move around the speed that our fingernails grow, but over geologic time scales, they can build up great amounts of stresses that are released in earthquakes. And so the largest earthquakes are going to happen on the west coast of the United States because this is at an area of a plate boundary where two plates are moving laterally or subducting under each other.
New York is actually in the middle of the North American plate.
So if we're not on a plate boundary, where do our earthquakes originate? Earthquakes originating from the middle of the plates usually happen at fault lines, which are places of stress in the rock. The fault lines in New York City are actually ancient remnants of past plate tectonic movement.
These ancient fault lines are actually from previous plate breakups and then recombinations. All of these faults are kind of parallel, going from north to south in Manhattan, at least of the maps I've seen.
Another major New York City fault line is the Dyckman Street Fault. This one is even more obvious from aerial views.
Here you can see a valley between Fort Tryon and Inwood Parks. This fault last produced an earthquake of magnitude 2 in 1989. So the rocks underneath us have stress fractures from millions of years ago. And this gets to another important detail about East Coast quakes. Eastern U.S. quakes can travel further and be felt more widely than Western U.S. quakes.
This is because the rocks here are older and colder than other seismically active places like the West Coast.
Older rocks are colder because they have less recently undergone deformation. And just like anything, when it cools down, it condenses, and the seismic waves can pass through it more easily.
So if you feel a shake in New York City, it could have originated many miles away.
Like in 2017, when residents of Brooklyn in the East Village reported shaking that was actually from a 4.1 quake in Delaware, 120 miles away. Or in April 2024, when the city was rattled by a 4.8 magnitude earthquake that originated in Tewksbury, New Jersey. The earthquake was an unusual event that revealed interesting geological secrets. Surprisingly, the epicenter experienced only minor shaking. Instead, the energy moved down an undiscovered fault and then up to the surface in different regions, affecting an estimated 45 million people.
So how do seismologists measure these earthquakes?
There is a global network of seismometers that is continuously monitoring ground motions across the globe. And as seismic waves pass through the Earth, they arrive at these seismometers at different times. We're able to back out those times and figure out the location and the origin time of the earthquake.
While seismographs provide a vital first line of defense in detecting these tremors, machine learning offers a powerful new approach, training neural networks to recognize earthquake signatures within the data itself.
In supervised machine learning, you input information, for example, seismic waveforms, and you train them to recognize earthquakes from noise. We can then discover many, many more earthquakes in the data that we previously hadn't seen. One interesting category of forecasting is aftershock forecasting. It's much more difficult, however, to predict the big one. That is kind of the holy grail of seismology.
So while seismographs can help detect earthquakes, they can't protect against them. So what does this mean for New York City?
The probability of a magnitude 5 earthquake occurring in the New York City area, it's about once every 100 years.
And with that last one being in 1884, that's almost 150 years. The good news is that most buildings would be fine with a magnitude 5 quake, but older buildings could have some damage.
If you find yourself in an earthquake situation, the best thing to do is to drop, cover, and hold on. The biggest hazards are from things falling, either inside or outside.
But is a 5.0 earthquake as high as it could get, or could it get higher? And what kind of damage could it bring to New York City? A 7.0 earthquake could cause considerable damage, and seismologists estimate that the Ramapo fault line, just north of the city, is capable of producing an earthquake of that magnitude. Part of the fault line is also a mile from the Indian Point nuclear power plant, which was recently decommissioned.
Because of the probability of a magnitude 7 on the Ramapo fault, they did reassess the safety of the Indian Point nuclear power plant and decided that it wasn't worth the risk of continuing to operate it.
So the next time you feel a rumble under your feet, it's probably just a subway train. But it's also a reminder that the Earth is always moving beneath our feet in this bustling metropolis. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, please like and leave a comment, and subscribe for more videos.